A lot of girls have slept with a number of guys, haven't had no significant gain from it, yeah? Had their heart broken.
Uh-huh.
Doesn't give them no money.
Yes.
Doesn't pay for camp for them to go home.
Uh-huh. I will relate with this one. Don't push me off.
Now listen.
Okay, hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm with Whitney again.
Hello.
And today we are gonna do a review to Bkchat season 2.
Is it called Bkchat or Bkchat?
It's Bkchat.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Bkchat.
People Bkchat say different
to the
things.
World and back. Yeah,
I think it's just because of the way it's spelled. But yeah, Bkchat.
So Bkchat, it's this show that came out like 4 months ago.
Yeah.
And it's basically just young people from London answering questions. Africans. Nigerians.
Nigerians.
Predominantly Nigerians.
Yeah.
We finally have one Ghanaian guy in there though.
But he's really mixed, you know.
Huh?
Like he's got like a lot of mixes. Like he's got Nigerian.
Oh, is he Nigerian as well?
Yeah.
You just can't.
He's got Lebanese.
Oh.
Yeah, like, and there's one more country that I'm not remembering.
How
that's
you know
in the Middle East. He tweeted
How do you
it.
Know this?
He tweeted it.
In the Middle East as well.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
He's mixed. He's mixed, like, but I think maybe like it's mostly Ghanaian.
He's mostly Ghanaian,
but,
yeah. Or he spoke Triyan. No, he spoke
Pidgin,
that was it.
Really,
that was
really
amazing.
Well.
Last
like,
week
really
it was?
Well.
No, it wasn't last week.
Yeah, it was anyways, a week before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was really good. So anyways, this is season 2.
Episode four.
So, yeah, it's basically our reactions to this episode. And we saw a teaser of it yesterday, and it's basically talking about being a sugar baby, basically dating older men for
on purpose, for like something
money
back.
Or trips abroad or whatever. So, yeah, it should be an interesting topic. I'm quite intrigued to hear what Lucas is going to say today. He's going to piss me off.
I hope Nini's in this episode.
I know. Yeah. Anyways, chat
it's our first
much.
Time watching it, by the way.
It's our first time watching it, so it should be interesting. Okay.
Okay.
Educated to escort is common today. Is this an acceptable hustle?
No.
The reason I feel like it's not acceptable is because it's not a great decision to send
Auntie Esther.
Women growing up. If I'm raising my child, Nina's
not there.
To work for her own and to eventually, you know, have a husband, get married. Now, if you start escorting yourself, like naturally people are going to look upon you and think, rah. It's almost like prostituting.
Friends are hoes. You know how friends are hoes? Allow it. Friends are washing.
They do that on a D-low. There's not a lot of people, like you said, people are not, you know, flamboyant about it. They don't show off about it. They like to discreetly do that. That's their own business. Now, if you're escorting, people are now being proud about it. They're walking around. Yes, they are. They're snapping it.
No, that's a lie. No. Sorry.
I know
that
like,
is a lie.
Girls, they will do it undercover.
Listen.
Like, they won't just be like, they won't put it on their bio on their
They'll
Instagram.
They'll snap by themselves all the time, take pictures by themselves
be
in
very,
different
very,
countries all
very,
the time.
Very, very undercover about
Listen.
It. I don't think they'll be out there about it.
You don't expose
As far as I'm concerned, daddy. None of my friends are escorts. As far as
Same here.
I am concerned.
Well, actually, not escorts, but... So I've got a friend of a friend who is not an escort, but she dates older men and they...
Benefits out of it.
They fly her out to the country, out of the country, they can buy them houses.
They might sign up to agencies or whatever, and
wow,
they're escorts
agencies.
And they go out.
Yeah, agencies. And well, some of the requirements are like, you have to be a certain like size.
Oh,
you're not
wow.
You're not allowed to have like stretch marks.
What?
Yeah, like there's some, so they have the requirements.
How'd you know this?
I went on the website.
What?
I was just curious. I was like, what does it take to be an escort? Because I just saw some
that
girl
is
in Dubai.
Random.
And I was like, she's clearly an escort. So I was like, how does this actually work? So I went online.
How'd you
like,
know that she was an escort?
Oh, it was just You know, like as Esther was saying, like, you know, she's snapping and this, like, you could just tell. So I was just,
I Google everything. Google is her friend.
Like, literally everything. So I was like, I went escort and there's like agencies and then you sign up and then I think some of them you have to like pay to
wrong.
Sign up. And then one of them was like, you can't have stretch marks, you can't have, you have to be like a size 10 or under. Like, there's so many like different requirements.
Wow. Enough.
I'm fat in the model world.
Well, I've kind of just made it. What, size 10?
Yeah, I'm a size 12.
But because so, yeah. I've got stretch marks as a boy.
Yeah, you can't be an escort.
I can't be an escort. Darn it!
Darn it!
I missed my boat. Down the drain. I missed it.
I promise you. Yeah.
I just want to arrange his eyebrows. But that's his eyebrows. If you use a spoolie, just to brush it out a little bit.
If he wants to now use pencil, you will now call him, oh, why are you doing makeup for? This is his eyebrows.
Just comb it out,
if
there's a stigma attached to being an escort, and that negative stigma spoils everything. Personally, for me,
he was wearing the same thing last week.
No, he wasn't. Yes, last week he was wearing a suit.
He was wearing the same.
What you mean in this? Stuff. You mean in this bit? Okay, in the kitchen.
Yeah.
He was wearing one suit. I was thinking, yay, pasta. Yeah, come today.
Sorry, but I didn't know it's the fashion. Like, he was wearing a
shirt
last week.
In the kitchen, he was wearing a sharp suit. I was thinking, rah, because he made a bad impression the week before, so he wanted to come sharp after he said how women was inferior, whatever nonsense like that in relationship. That was a really bad comment. That was a
dumb thing to say.
Max, that was a really, really bad comment.
You took the L there, mate. So next,
last week, he came in with like one suit. I was like, hey, but you're saying he's wearing the same top.
He took the L with that one, by inferior.
In this modern day and age, how? You want to say this?
How?
What a wow.
Okay. How? Anyways, let me continue.
This generation is kind of prone to.
Do you know, I call these glasses fuckboy glasses. You know that? I actually call them fuck. If you come anywhere near me and you're wearing those glasses, just walk past because they are fuckboy glasses to me. Okay?
Why?
Nah, man. I feel like all guys who wear that, they are cheaters. They are manipulators. They are abusers. Yeah. Yeah, I see you.
I don't know if I agree with that.
Fuck boy glasses.
I guess it's because...
And mostly Nigerian boys are wearing them.
You know what? Yeah, I'm not even going to say anything. I'm not even going to say anything. I tried, but
she shut it down. So it's true, though.
I get what you're saying. I actually understand what you're saying.
The You know what? You're about demons. They don't want to wear these glasses.
No one has broken my heart and...
He's so cute. Not Lucas. Sorry. No, not Lucas.
She's talking about
Lucas
Omar.
Is cute as well. I'm talking about Omar. Cute, Omar is cute.
I don't know.
What? Why?
Apparently he's short.
Oh.
That literally...
My heart is broken.
That literally wipes.
Ghana men, why?
That literally wipes.
Why? I was rooting for
my
you.
My friend saw him and she goes,
we were all rooting for
you.
She
said, Whitney, I think you need to cancel the fancy. I'm like, why? She's like, he's short. Like, no. Like, I was like,
the council blocking the East End, but yet you're on a yacht in Dubai. Like, but you've not put no one in the background and you went there by yourself.
You don't snap who you're with.
What's going on here? Do you understand? Questions start getting thrown out. And then all of a sudden, stories come back.
No, because I've been away with someone and I didn't snap them and they wasn't a sugar daddy.
True.
Do you get what I mean?
True.
Like, you could be just private about who you're with. I've literally been... He's not a sugar daddy. He's not a sugar daddy.
No, I'm joking.
We're actually the same age.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. So you could go away with someone and not snap them. It doesn't mean that you're with
keep them private.
Yeah. So.
But the majority of the time is because they are a sugar daddy.
Okay.
Let's be real about that. How about it?
Okay.
Are you with some guy that's 85 and
you? You tried it, Lucas.
85-year-olds capable of having sex.
Well, Hugh Hefner is like 85 now, isn't he?
Is he?
He's still
active. So I guess it depends on the individual.
With those bunnies, honey, like maybe a. But he took it far though. He took it far.
Sugar daddies. Okay, what is a sugar daddy? From what age?
The one that
is it meant to be like? Okay, so we're in our 20s. So what?
Early 20s.
Anyway, what would we classify what age would we classify as sugar daddy?
I'm 21.
Can I go out with a 4-year-old?
Yeah, you can go out with a 4-year-old.
That's okay.
That's okay. Oh my gosh. I would date Idris Elba like yesterday, okay? He's like 44. I don't care. He is beautiful. I love him.
Okay. Is it the age or is it the nature of
the... I think it's the nature of the relationship. Of the relationship.
So if it's that buying you
and
stuff...
And a bit of the age as well, because the majority of the time, they are much older than you.
Yeah.
That is... You hear these stupid stories that, yo, girls go places, they come back and nothing was the same. Like, you go, you let one old man's karma come all up inside you and it's the next thing. He's got body.
I'm done. I'm done. What's he wearing? What's his hat? Oh my God, I'm done with this boy.
He looks like a sugar daddy now. He looks like a sugar daddy right now. What's it look? What's his swag?
He said
you look like a sugar daddy right now, Lucas. And you said
that. They're the same people that are on benefits, that are fucking up this whole system, like, and then they're getting paid by uncles to live a certain luxurious lifestyle. Mm. It's taking a piss. The reason I'm mad, because about £400 comes out of my flipping paycheck for tax. Do you understand? No, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it.
You tried it if you're gonna wear ripped jeans
Lucas,
your boxers isn't gonna show, right?
Lucas is wearing ripped denim and his boxers are showing through the hole of the distressing of the jeans. You don't do that, boo.
I'm saying you define hustle. Now we have to look at acceptable. People said, is it an acceptable hustle? For it to be acceptable, you have to assume that the person is subservient to society's views.
Ooh, or subservient.
Here he goes with the words again.
Oh. Oh my God, this game is so ridiculous. I can't.
Damn. To Google.
What's acceptable or not? Just
a few minutes ago, you were talking about his eyebrows, and I said, "Go, my friend, get out, my friend."
I don't want to hear it.
Do you know what?
Let's
realized,
just play that again.
Lucas is like a watered down version of an alpha male, and the reason I say that is because a man said he escorting is okay to do, not remembering that a man has sisters, not remembering that he's gonna have a girl or he has a girl, and the question in question now is, are you going to let your girl do that job, knowing that there's a possibility she's going to off the pan? That's what he needs to begin to think about.
We understand that people hide under...
He said off the pan! Off the pan! That's so aff.
That is so... It
is. If you're an escort, you're going to give your time to somebody. You're just appearing in places. You're not sleeping with the person. Otherwise, if the person is sleeping with you is rape. If you haven't consented to it, then they're raping you. You should go and report to the police.
Thing. Doesn't it say this one? Like,
yeah.
Points. That is hilarious.
I love Igbo people. I love them. Oh my gosh. Hilarious.
A lot of girls have slept with a number of guys, haven't had no significant gain from it, yeah? But had their heart broken.
Uh-huh.
Doesn't give them no money.
Yes.
No money to pay for camp for them to go home.
Uh-huh. I will relate with this one.
Money to now go and take myself back to my father's house. I had to fork out money. Michelle!
Whitney.
From Greenwich to Hackney.
Oh my God.
It's not a small journey. It was like £30. 1 o'clock in the night.
Damn.
Michelle.
Did they let you stay over?
No, I didn't want to stay over. Okay. I wanted to go home. Like, okay. I want to go home to my own bed. And this was apparently my boyfriend.
Oh my God. even. That's horrible.
It was abuse. It was abuse. I got valid. My heart was broken. Okay.
Actually,
with that one, my heart didn't break. That was a very easy relationship for me to get over. It just took Basaba for me to get over him. It was fine. But
what she said.
What she said was gospel. Like, listen, we have busted open for these guys, yeah, and they haven't offered us nothing. So if one guy is coming with $1,000, of course you're gonna do it.
Of course.
And especially if you're in that situation. The whole thing is that you don't get yourself in that situation. Yeah. That's why I will never even be like, I'm gonna escort and sit there and look pretty, because it can lead to that situation easily.
Yeah.
So that's all it is. So of course you're gonna get, of course, if you're an escort, you're going to get yourself, you're gonna say, oh, this is fine, this is easy. Why not bust it open for someone that's gonna give you a grand if you bust it open for someone that just gave you nothing? Why not? Why not?
Oh my gosh, okay.
Sorry. It actually
touched, so. I relate to her so much, because I say this all the time to females. You are getting your heart broken. You are sleeping with this person. He could even be married, or he's got a girlfriend, or he's not available to you because he don't want to be in a relationship. You know, he wants to do this, and you know, he's not ready because he wants to do that. And you're just there like fried rice. You're just sitting there watching him like Mumu, like, oh, okay. No, listen, if you're gonna get yourself in this hoation, you're hoeing in this situation, so it's a hoation.
I like that.
You need to be smart. You have to be a smart hoe. You can't be a dumb hoe. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Be a smart hoe.
If you're going to give yourself to somebody who is not even available to you, you need to make sure you're getting something out of it.
Yeah.
He needs to buy you a car. He needs to buy you a house. He needs to start a business for you.
Long-term
investments. He needs to put your name on the lease, by the way.
Yeah.
Okay. Your name on the lease. He needs to do all these things. If you're gonna be a hoe, you have to be a smart hoe. Don't be a dumb hoe and invest your heart and your body into this idiot who don't want you, and then your heart is broken and you're like, all men are the same. Oh, I'll never find anybody.
No, she said he doesn't pay for your cab home. That touched home.
Don't be a hoe. If you're going to be a hoe, you need to be a smart hoe.
Yeah.
Don't be those girls that just have bag and shoe to show for the hoeing they've done for all these years. Like, do you know what I mean? Yeah. Have something of substance. What's it called?
Substance.
Yes, have something of substance. I was gonna say sustenance.
Forget it.
You're not serious with your life.
But the point here is that if you're gonna bust it open for someone that hasn't offered you anything, you're gonna bust it open for someone that is offering you all of this, and that's why you just don't get yourself in that situation. Yeah. That's what I said. Most of the time, these girls, they go into escorting thinking they're not gonna sleep with the guy, but when the situation presents itself to them, then it's a different scenario altogether.
Listen, I like this girl, you know.
That's it. We're not fucking. Is she then a prostitute?
Have you noticed that every time he speaks,
the girls smile?
The girls are just like,
they're just smiling.
Like,
do you know what it is? It's because he hardly speaks. That's literally what they do. Hardly speaks. Yeah. So when he speaks.
So if escorting is supposed to be a positive thing, a good thing, a part of your lifestyle, then why won't you come out with your chest and say, listen, I am an escort?
Mm-hmm.
Because you know you're being a hoe. Because you know why, the reality, all jokes aside,
it's true.
It's not a positive thing.
No,
you can't
go
to your mum and say, listen, mum, what job do you have, darling? Mum, I'm an escort. Like, really? Like, you know it's not right. Sometimes it's not even about
what. Wow, that's so, like, like, yeah, he's Ghanaian, he's in London, and he's got green hair. That's, like, unheard of. And speaks pidgin. That is unheard of. So I think it makes him more sexy.
Attractive.
Omer. Omer.
Goodbye.
I'm joking. Goodbye. Come on.
Goodbye.
He's too young for me anyway.
Yeah, he's 24.
Their mum knows where the dough is coming from, but okay, it's helping one, though, at the time. It's not justifiable, it makes it a good thing, but every hustle is different for your reasons. If you're hustling because you want to go put a big H belt on your mind, then you're very sick. But if you're going to go and touch the girl, don't give it to your marge or invest
in it.
You're doing what you have to do to get by, so you don't do that anymore.
Certain lifestyle. And part of that lifestyle is to, rather than go out and get a good job, they want to, they're just lazy.
I just see her mouth. That's all I see, and teeth. That's all I see when she talks, you know. Her mouth is just so big.
When she talks, I see her hair. Because she used to like flick it, like, do you understand? Do you understand? That's what she used to do. That's what I see. I see her hair.
I just see her mouth. Let's
bring it back to Black London. Let's not talk about general London. Let's talk about Black London and the stigmas that follow, like you said, a lady booking a trip to Dubai. A lot of my babes in Nige this year in the Christmas period, you know, and my real uncles are showering them with.
Don't push me off!
Now listen.
Oh my god! Oh my gosh!
Sorry.
Winnie,
sorry.
She pushed me!
Because this relates to both of us!
Oh my gosh! Ow!
I was dating this guy.
Oh my lord.
We will call him.
Oh my gosh!
Give me a name, because the name I'm going to give is so babe.
Coffee. Let's call him Coffee.
We'll call him Coffee. Coffee. Coffee, that's how I say his name, Coffee. But Coffee apparently liked me for a while. Yeah? He liked me for a while. He wanted to get to know me and stuff. But because I will go to Ghana every Christmas, he thought I had an uncle sponsoring me, so he thought that I was Michelle.
A finesse chick. What?
He wasn't here when we were sat on this bed.
Wait, say it
on
again.
On Turkish Airlines. Wait, trying to find tickets to get to Ghana. He wasn't here. He wasn't here when I was like,
wait.
Can you say
that bit again? No, you said because he thought I was Michelle.
No, he thought that I was one of those girls that had an uncle out there that will sponsor my trip. And
thank you.
I'm there. That's what he thought. Oh, no. He thought I was them, and I was really hurt by that.
Yeah.
Because man, used my own money to get. We used our own money. Like, he wasn't here when we was booking tickets. When we had to go in now, go and spend 24 hours in Turkey, when the man said, he really wasn't there. When we had to be in Lisbon for the day.
We had to do like.
We have suffered, like, getting there. It's not even like. Because it's just things that have just happened, and now you're telling me it's because of one uncle in Accra has sponsored my trip, and you thought I was one of those girls. Lucas is about to piss me off. That he's about to piss me off. He's about to piss me off.
Did I say that?
I wasn't well today, but now I'm angry.
She has vim.
Like, BA was telling me $1,000. Turkish was telling me $500. Am I really
going to go? Exactly. Ghana is not cheap.
It's not cheap to get there.
We would do the transit flights and go Turkey for
We're going to land in the same Kotaka airport, aren't we? The same airport we're going to land in, aren't we? Go. I'm so angry.
We are going to land in the same airport. That's the same uncle that will look
at my passport and say, oh, where have you come from? And I'm like, London. Okay. Have you got anything for me? Like, no, uncle, have you got anything for you? We're going to land in that same. We're going to fight that same free belt. British Airways will be there. Turkish Airlines airline will be here. And TAP will be here. And we'll all be there fighting the same battles. And I don't understand.
To get our luggage.
So yeah, we'll be fighting the same battles to get our luggage.
Oh.
And you're telling me an uncle paid for my ticket.
Yeah,
don't piss me off. Why can't I go to Ghana every year if I want to?
Yeah.
Why does it seem that I have to be going there because of someone is sponsoring my ticket? I could be going there because I want to go to Ghana. And me and Michelle wanted to go to Ghana. Yeah. We wanted to just go to Bukka and eat Bangu. That's all we wanted to do. And you're telling me that someone sponsored my ticket when I paid for it, but he
was very, very ignorant though.
That guy was
very ignorant.
And I'm very glad it didn't work out between me and him.
Amen.
Gosh, man. Ew. We'll do a story time about that one next time. Ew.
We should do a story time.
I will do a story time as well.
Oh my gosh.
We can do it. About the guys that we've dated. Yeah, but anyways. I'm so
That's
angry.
Not our lives. Lucas is going to piss us off.
He's going to piss us off.
Let's continue.
Oh my gosh. I need to breathe.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You know what I'm saying? Let's bring it back to the gospel. You know what I'm saying? Let's talk about LDN. So 2016 December. It was like, no, 2016 December. Ghana,
Nigeria. Don't push me again. He said Ghana, Nigeria. That's it. Wait till he finishes. Let him land, Whitney. Let him land. Wait. Just let him land before you push me off the chair again. Okay.
Epic and right with London women who, if, even if you know, do you know Lekon in Nigeria? Do you know Kwame in Accra? Why are you there? Okay, cool, you've gone to experience a holiday. Now, the problem with that is the stigma that the women that go there that actually do the let me mini rock on one. Because he's about to shower me with that paper.
Oh my god!
It's the good life. Again, me, morally, I knock it because my wife can't end up like that. But if you want to be a bad dude and you own your shit and you want to go to Ghana, Nigeria and bust it open and crack it wide for the squad, by all means.
A lot of girls went to Ghana, Nigeria last year, 2016, innit?
You were there. Thank God I didn't go Ghana. 2016.
Yeah,
you can't even be chatting about me. I was in London this year, but it is easy to do that.
It's easy to do it
in Ghana.
I mean,
haven't been to Nigeria, so I don't know. But I feel like it'll be another level because
it is
the Nigerian men in London already are another level. Yeah. So I can only imagine the ones that are in Nigeria.
Bro, who do you know? There, your mom's here. Your dad's here. Family's here. Christmas is your family. Like, why are you not? Why are you not? You want to go and lose your life to the Lekki boys, yeah? The Voti boys of Lekki. VI. So they can give you nice finances to come back home and do 6 months. Then you go back again. VI.
It's not here, you know, where everything is closed. Yeah. Or like on Christmas Day.
Yeah, it's actually lit. It's so much fun. There's so much to do.
And if you enjoy it, why can't you go back again and again?
It's hot as well. There's people from here, America, from everywhere.
It's fun. It's actually fun.
You meet
fun.
New people. It's
you meet
a
new
lot
people.
Of fun.
You make new friends.
So
it's actually fun.
Why
so why
is the problem?
Is it that all. Okay? I'm not gonna go so that people might not think that I've got an uncle like that. Like, no. Come on, like just
that
go
as well.
Mm-hmm. I met this guy. Yeah, I hadn't even hugged this guy. This guy gave me 2 bags. Hold on. He gave me 2 bags. I said, yeah.
Two bags is what? £2,000.
Now. The guy said to me.
Oh, that 2,000
though. Of course she did.
Did you run with the 2,000?
No, yeah, I took
no,
the 2,000.
Of course you're gonna take the 2,000. Hello. I'm sorry. I'm gonna give it back to you. I'm like, okay, thank you.
Nah.
Put it into my bag.
Nah.
And just, you know,
I have suffered by trying to take the high road. Now I'll take the low road and I'll take the money.
Can you let it go?
I have suffered by taking the high road. I'm an independent woman. I got this. That I have suffered.
Oh,
so now
baby.
I take the low road.
It hasn't come to that. Yes, but listen, I say this all the time. As women, we have so much power that we don't even realize. If we just bump, closed our legs, yeah, men would not even have the opportunity to cheat on you,
yeah,
to look elsewhere, because all of us would have our self-worth and we'll say no. Like, for example, I'm not gonna sleep with you, I've just met you. No, you're married. No, you've got a girlfriend.
Yeah.
No, I'm saving myself for marriage, or I'm saving myself for the person who I love, or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I mean? We have so much power.
But we don't know it.
I can't say it's our fault, but I feel like
we're allowing it to happen.
Yeah, we don't do ourselves justice, I guess, because we don't know our worth.
Yeah, and like be the side girl. Or if it was all on the same fit team and we all wanted the same thing, we would get it.
Yeah. Do you know how many guys would be proposing and wanting to marry you if you said, you know what, I want to wait till marriage? I'm sorry.
And all, everyone is.
I'm sorry. And everyone was doing that. Literally, if back in the day, what, 1950s or whatever.
That's why they were getting married.
That's what you did. Yeah. You
you date, you court, you would wait until you get married and have sex. That's how it was. But now people are just
busting it open.
So
women don't mind doing the side thing.
You don't need to get married because you're already playing husband and wife anyway. People are entertaining the ideas of being a side chick. Yeah. It's fun. Know your worth, innit? That was it. I feel like it stems from a lot of previous experiences, relationships, you know, family. You know, all of that can build that hoish character in you. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't know. It's sad.
But then some really women might argue that they just want to have sex.
That's true.
You know what?
There are just some freaks that just like to
have sex. Yes. They just want to have sex. So it's a tricky one.
All of that is a spiritual thing, by the way. That's all spiritual, you know? You can't tell me that, oh, I just will enjoy having sex with everybody. It's not cool. Like, no, like, there's something wrong there. Like, there's something wrong. You can't tell me that's normal. I'm so sorry. I remember back in the day, I was young. I was like 16, 17. I'm getting my nails done in the nail salon, and this girl was like just chatting about sex, and she was like, oh my gosh, I can't go a month without it.
Really?
And she turned to me. In it?
You were 16.
I was like, yeah. Like, these times, I'm a virgin, so I'm like, huh? Yeah.
You understand?
So that is the end of Bkchat season 2 episode 4. Very, very interesting topic. Like, I've laughed. I have screamed. She's She pushed me. I've been pushed off my chair.
It was interesting. What do I think of it? I mean, if you want to be a whore, as Michelle said, be a smart whore.
You have to be a smart whore.
Personally, I can't go down that route.
No.
I just can't.
No.
Even for me to sit in a company of a man knowing that he's just paying me just to be there. And I don't want to be there, but because it's paying me, that's cool as well at the same time.
Yeah.
I liked, what is it, Reva?
Yeah, it's Reva.
Reva. I liked what Reva said.
She's smart. She's very, very smart. I love her notions. I love
like how she
says and how she thinks.
She presents her theories.
Logical as well. Yeah. Like, she thinks about every aspect.
Yeah.
So it's really important.
I liked what all of them said. The girls.
The girls, yeah.
Everyone has different points of views with that. But yeah. Uncle Sugar Daddy.
I agree with you there. Yeah, it's not, to be honest, it's not the way forward, but if that's your hustle, that's your hustle. And if you're gonna be a hoe, just be a smart one. Like, don't let bag and shoe be what you are known for. Oh, she has nice bags and shoes. That's all, that's it. Your life, like, but I personally would not advise anybody in. Also, what about karma? Like, I feel like, I don't know, I feel like,
especially when you're dealing with someone that's married, yeah?
Like,
when you eventually maybe get married, somebody could be there
doing that to you. Now you're young.
Now you're younger, your body's thick and everything's in place. But when you're your boobs are sagging, you got a baby crying in the background, and your husband decides to go with some young thing, how are you gonna feel?
Listen, these older men, they like their young things. So fair enough.
But one thing, they will never ever leave their wives for you.
For you, yeah.
They won't. They
like their young girls. Like, for now, you're young, you know, you're ripe, everything is great.
Yeah,
but as soon as you turn 35, they'll go and get
the next
younger.
The 90s babies are coming up, you know? The 90 babies.
25 or whatever. So yeah. It's like, this business is like being a footballer.
It's not a long-term thing. Like, so you might as well get the most out of it and then make a long-term thing out of it.
You have to have a contingency plan. Like, what are you going to do after? Seriously, you can't do it forever. So you have to be really smart in how you carry out this. But I just think karma. Karma is a bitch.
Just don't do it.
Karma is a bitch. Like, it's gonna...
Don't have an uncle.
No. One day...
Be your own uncle. Make your own money.
Be your own boss, chick, isn't it?
Treat yourself.
Be your own boss. Because one day you will get married, and then a 20-something year old will be doing the same. Battery died. So anyway, one day you are going to get married and same thing will happen to you. So just think about the karma and what else.
And just because I go to Ghana every year doesn't mean I have an uncle out there. Thank you. Oh, I'm getting sick, man. Sorry.
You're ruining my outro. You're fighting with my plants. My fake plants. Anyways, get it together. Q, get it together. Okay. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. And comment as well. I'll catch you guys later. Bye.
Bye.
Could you arrange the flowers a little bit better?
How? Like, I don't know.